वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज रिलेटेड टू SCI एंड टुडे वी हैव टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग. ओके, सो हियर इज द रिसोर्स फ्रॉम विच आई डिलीवर द लेक्चर टू यू. ओके, सो दिस इज रिसोर्स उप्स इंट्रोडक्शन एंड OM. One minute, okay. OOM, object oriented modeling of user interface design. Okay. So we will start with our topic. Okay. First for introduction. Okay. So object oriented programming and introduction by Dr. Pradeep Yamiyawar. So let's start with our topic. Okay, so there are you know already about the languages, programming languages. Okay, so we have in SCI there are two types of paradigm, programming paradigm. Okay, so first is procedural programming paradigm. Okay, simply PPP. Okay, and then object oriented programming paradigm, OPPP. Okay. So the objects are states and behaviors, software objects, fields and methods, data encapsulations, public interface, object based applications and benefits of object based application development. Okay, so these are the all you can say topics, okay, related to object oriented programming. And then classes we discuss like definition, blueprint of similar objects, instantiating objects from class. Okay, for example here we provide examples. Okay, then object oriented principles, encapsulance, inheritance, interface, polymorphisms, okay, packages and API. So we will discuss some of the topic related to object oriented programming and the relationship related with HCI. Okay, already you know about object oriented programming, so in some topic we will skip some information, okay, because already you know about this programming structure, object oriented programming. Okay, so in procedural programming paradigm, okay, the programming unit is a function. Okay, program is divided into self contained and maintainable parts called modules like ABCD, and then a module contains procedures, self contained code that carries out a single task. Okay, like XYZ, and then a function is a self-contained code returning value to the calling procedure. Okay, so there are modules, procedures, okay, self-contained codes like functions, okay, in PPP. So in 3P, simply we can say 3P, all computations are done by applying functions. Okay, and procedural programming paradigm separates data of program from instructions that manipulates the data. So here you can see a diagram related to this procedural programming paradigm. Okay, there is the application. Okay, applications is divided into four modules. Then module C. So module C carries out three tasks, X, Y, Z. Then again procedure Y calls function P and Q, and then data input. Okay, then code is processed according to input. So function processes the data and then we get data output. And here in case of object oriented programming paradigm, okay, OOPP, so this paradigm it describes a system as it exists in real life based on interactions among real objects. Okay, and the application is modeled as collection of related objects that interact and do the task. And the programming unit is a class representing collection of similar real world objects. Okay, so programming start with abstractions of useful real world objects and classes, and then application is divided into multiple packages like ABCD, and the package is a collection of classes fulfilling groups of tasks or functionality. Then a class is an encapsulated data plus code definition of collection of similar real world objects. Then object oriented programming paradigm binds together data and the instruction that manipulates the data into a class. So here you can see a diagram related to this paradigm, OOPS paradigm, okay. So applications divided collection of four packages, okay. And then package B contains three classes, PQR, okay, these are the classes. Then object X of class R, okay. So class R have, class R encapsulates seven methods, okay. And there is the data X, Y, Z related to those methods, okay, three attributes. And then you can see the message to invoke, okay, method four. So ask object X to do task method 4, okay. So data is given 381, okay. So object encapsulates data plus code, and then we will get the data or object out after processing those methods and data, okay. So in real world we can see lots of objects, okay. So here are, you can see some objects from the real world, okay. So objects are key to understanding object oriented technology, and simply look around you and you will find many examples of real world objects. So here is the example related to objects. So real world objects share two characteristics, they all have state and behavior. So you can see dog, okay, state, name, color, breed, hungry, okay, then behavior, barking, fetching, wagging and tail. Then bicycle as object, state, current gear, current speed, current pedal cadence, okay. This is a gear based cycle, bicycle, okay. And the behavior is changing gear, changing pedal cadence and applying brakes. Again, there are two objects, okay. Try and identify the states and behavior of these two objects. So it is, you simply can say, this is the homework, okay, table lamp, DVD player. So you have to first identify the states, then you have to identify the behavior. So mostly states are the same, but it is related to on and off, okay, and also behavior is also related to on and off. And in case of DVD player, the states are changing, okay, forward, backward, okay, play, pause. So according to that you have behavior also, okay. So here is the answer related to this. So objects, okay, table lamp, so state on off already I told you, and according to that behavior, turning on and turning off. Again some change, okay, in case of DVD player. So on off is the main state, and current volume and current stations is important here. So and again behavior, in behavior turn on, turn off, okay, increase volume, decrease volume, seek, scan and tune, okay. But again some behavior like play, pause and forward and backward, so that can be applied here also, okay. Then software objects, fields and methods. So software objects like methods, behavior, okay, and there are fields and states. So the fields and methods are interact with each other, okay, in case of software objects. So object stores its state information in fields attributes mostly, and exposes its behavior through methods member functions, okay. So here you can see software object like shape, okay. So there are different shapes, and so for that they have different you can say methods, okay, for square, rectangle, okay, hexagon, pentagon, circle, and they have fields or states. So again data encapsulations. So objects method can only change objects internal state, hiding this internal states, and require all interaction to be performed through an object method is known as data encapsulations, okay. So simply change gears, brake, change cadence, okay, then fifth gear, then speed 90 rpm, okay, 18 mph, okay. So these are the data related simply methods are here applied for on the data. Okay, so it's simply here hiding the internal states and only requires with the objects method. Okay, so that provide data encapsulation. Then here again you can see more about data encapsulation. So window object, okay, so change net, change width, change location, maximize and minimize. Okay, then again there is data related to height, width, color and locations. Okay, so actually the data is hidden here. Then public interface. So other objects can change the state of an object by using only those methods that are exposed to the outer world through a public interface, and this helps in data security. So object is an encapsulation of data attributes as well as methods, functions. Okay, so simply turn on and turn off volume. Okay, so here is the interface, then here is the object set-top box. Okay, for viewing the television. So private, public, volume, public turn off, private decode, public set channel, public volume, and again there is data related to this different methods for the objects. So current, volume, current channel, power, etc. Then again you can see here some public interface related to objects. So simply object is an encapsulation of data attributes as well as method interface. So here is the set x real, set y, set z real. Okay, so get x, get y, get z interface, and there are methods, and there is the you can say data for related to this object. So x, y, z. Okay, then average. Okay, again object based applications for shape. So here you can see power, circuit, interface. Okay, turn and turn on and off. Okay, so we can represent different shapes for different applications. So receiver, then tuner interface, tuning, if amplifier. Okay, then audio amplifier. So interface, volume, positive and negative. Okay, so there are electronic components in different shapes. Then connectors and interfaces to control the object's operation. Okay, then at last user interface and actions. So benefits of object-based application development. So first, modularity. Source code for an object can be maintained independently in a class. Once created, an object can be easily passed around inside the system, like example class mesh, class string, class window, etc. Then information hiding. By interacting only with an object's method, the detail of its internal implementation remain hidden from the outside world. Already we see about this interface, example like interface, mesh interface, string interface, windows, etc. Then code reuse. So if an object already exists, perhaps written by another software developer, you can use that object in your program. That is the important part of the object-oriented programming. And this allows specialists to implement, test, debug complex task-specific objects, which you can then trust to run in your own code or environment. So like example, standard classes, available packages with which can reuse using their interfaces. Then next is the pluggability and debugging. So if a particular object turns out to be problematic, you can simply remove it from your application and plug in a different object as its replacement. So this is an analogous to fixing mechanical problems in the real world. And if a bolt breaks, you replace it and not the entire machine. So again, you can see collection of objects that share common attributes and behavior methods. So like animals, airplanes, flowers, birds, vehicles, humans, stationary animals, okay, or sports devices or tools, okay. Then structures, class structures. So class, like here, animal attributes and behavior. Okay, then class, vehicle attributes and behavior. So different types of classes available. Okay, Then class blueprint of similar objects. So factory of cycle shops, some make and model with same features and same components. So build from same blueprint, and this blueprint is called a class. So here you can see class cycle used to create all other cycles. Okay. So in object oriented terms, we say that cycle is an instance of class of objects known as cycles. And a class is the blueprint from which individual objects are created, and the attributes and operation defined by a class are for its objects, not for itself. Okay, and the class is a logical construct, and object has physical reality. Then class definitions. So you can see here example. Okay. So classes are passive and which do not communicate but are used to create objects with which interacts. Okay. So you can see there are two objects. Okay. Same objects. So but there is a change. Okay. So parameters like cadence 10, speed 5 km/h, gear is equal to 3. Then cadence 15, speed 2 km/h, gear is equal to 4. Okay. Cycle class. Okay. So there is object class cycle 1 and cycle 2, and the responsibility of creating using new cycle object belong to say some other class in the your application. So here is the pseudocode related to class cycle. You can see here. Okay, change cadence, change gear, speed up, apply brakes, and print states. Okay. So simply in class cycle you have a cadence, speed and gear in integer. Okay, so they represent states. Then you have methods. Okay, void change gate. Okay, print state, speed up, apply brake, change cadence. So these are the methods. These are the behavior related to the class cycle. Okay, so define interactions with world with interface. Okay, so the cycle one and cycle two are instances of class cycle. Then in instantiating objects from class. So class demo, class that creates two separate cycle objects and invoke their methods. Already we can see in previous slides, already seen. And then here is the class cycle demo. Okay, the pseudocode is given here, so I will not discuss about this pseudocode. Okay. So this program is stored in cycledemo.java. Okay, so this is Java related code, and the main class is a class that contains one method called main, and the main method contains a series of instructions to create objects and to tell those objects to do things. Okay, so you can see a diagram here, programming support. Okay, like class math, class state, class draw. Okay, so define main class, class with main method. Then create instances of required objects, then interface math, interface math, and interface math. Okay, then Java APIs and Java packages. So after that, creating instances, you have to write instructions for object communication to build applications, and then objects at last delete objects created. Okay, so simply next is the object oriented principles, encapsulation. So encapsulation is the mechanism that binds together the code and the data it manipulates and keeps both safe from outside interface and misuse. Okay, so there is a simple example you can see. So to avoid misuse, okay, and it provides the secure you can say data, secure the data. So there is the private area, okay, private data and private functions. Then there is the public area and public data, public functions. So entry allowed only the related data objects, okay, and it's make the you can say object oriented programming for misusing the data or method. Okay. Then object-oriented principles, next one is the inheritance. Okay, inheritance is the process by which one object acquires the properties of another object. Okay, and by use of inheritance, an object need only define all of its characteristics that make it unique within its class. okay, and it can inherit its general attributes from its parents, and this will be clear from here. You can see the example, okay. So there is a, again, bicycle class, okay. So mountain bikes, road bikes, tandem bikes are all share the characteristics of bicycles, okay. So there is a current speed, current pedal, cadence, current gear, okay. And then object again, object oriented programming allow classes to inherit commonly used state and behavior from other classes. So here is the bicycle, then you have mountain bikes, road bikes and tandem bikes, okay. So bicycle now becomes the super class of mountain bikes, road bike and tandem bikes. Again, yet each has some features that makes them different, okay. So tandem bicycles have two seats and two sets of handlebars. Then road bikes have drop handlebars, and some mountain bikes have an additional chain ring giving them a lower gear ratio. And creating subclass at beginning of a class, use the extend keyword, okay, followed by name of the class to inherit from the main class, okay, super class. So here is the Java pseudocode, or you can say simply class mountain bike extend bicycle, okay. Subclass for subclass. So next is the interface. So public methods from the object interface with the outside world, okay. Interface is a group of related methods with empty bodies, okay, or simply we can say pure virtual functions, okay. So menu, publicly available terms like dosa, idli, tea, coffee, ice cream, bonvita, Pepsi, soup, pudding are used, okay. So there is the class related to hotel or canteen, okay. So simply we have you can say food related, you can say restaurant or hotel. So there are two sub classes like class sorry hotel and class office canteen, okay. So implementation one and implementation two, and then again implementation kitchens, okay, for different classes. And there are the options of food menu, okay. So client one and client two orders the items, okay, shown here, okay, food items, okay. So simply interface or kitchen constant should not change, define behavior and does not have implementation, and client not bothered of implementations, okay. So we know the interface, and again some different way. So public method from object interface with the outside world, and interface is a group of related methods with empty bodies, okay, or simply pure virtual functions. So there are the interfaces, okay. So it is the related printer class related to printer. So there are two classes, okay, two types of printers. So dot matrix and inkjet, and then simply we have plus 5 volt, okay, ground, x, tx, tn. These are the communications channel related input, okay. So uses iPrinter to connect, okay. There is the CPU. So simply there is here you can see a interface in a different way, and here is the interface in different way. So class as implementation of interface. So a bicycle's behavior, if specified as an interface, might appear as below. Here you can see in diagram and with pseudocode. So there is a pseudocode related to class bicycle, implement iBicycle, okay. So it iBicycle is the interface for that bicycle class, okay. And you can see different implementations related to classes like change cadence, okay, change gear, speed up, apply brake and print states, okay. So these are the interfaces related to iBicycle, okay. So to implement interface, the name of your class would change, okay, and you use the implementers keywords in the class declaration. Again, interfaces define an application. So interface makes a class formal about the behavior it promises to provide. Then interfaces form a contract between the class and outside world, and this contract is enforced at build time by the compiler. Okay, so here you can see first diagram. There is a implement IA and implement IB, okay. So uses IA and uses IB, And again, if your classes claims to implement an interface, all methods defined by that interface must appear in its source code before the class will successfully compile. Okay, so again in next diagram you can see unused E, okay, then implements IE, implement IC and implement ID. So server objects and client objects, user uses IC and uses ID. Okay, so these are the different interfaces for applications. Then object oriented principles for polymorphisms. Okay, so polymorphisms from Greek meaning many forms is a features that allows same interface to be used for multiple class of actions depending on context. Okay, so here is the animal class, so there is a sound subclass. Okay, so cat have different sound and dog have different sound, you can see here. So simply this example shows the polymorphisms related to sound for animals. Then packages and API. So package is a namespace that organizes a set of related classes and interfaces like a folder. Okay. Then software written in the Java programming language, hundreds or thousands of reusable classes, and it makes sense to keep things organized by placing related classes and interfaces into packages. And then Java platform provide class library which has huge number of classes organized in packages, which is also called API. Okay, so here you can see the API related to this standard nut and bolts related to application programming interface API. So in Java, okay, Java APIs. So application 1, application 2, application 3. So there are Java, AWT, utils, swings, RMIs, SQL and security. Okay, and these are literally thousands of classes to choose from. This allows you to the programmer to focus on the design of your particular application rather than the infrastructure required to make it work. Okay, and these are the references for more about object oriented programming paradigm. Okay, then next we go for another slides. Okay, so 1 minute. Okay, so the next slide is here. This is the last one slide. Okay, then we will complete our lecture after this slide. So start with the topic again, object oriented modeling of user interface design. Already we know about the two paradigm and their structure. Okay, understand the structures of OOPs. So here we discuss interaction, interface object, interface actions, methodology of OOUID, object oriented modeling using UML. Okay, use cases, analysis object, task scenarios, dialog transition chart, dialog component, specification, interface prototype and task flow. And then we go for design, model view, controller architecture, design classes, MVC, and then case study. Okay, so simply there is the interactions. Okay, so interactions is like end user relies on mental models to predict behavior of the system. Okay, and mental model is the internal representation of structures, okay, and behavior of the system or reality. Okay, I will close this class here. Okay, we will discuss this slide in next lecture. Okay, so thank you. So we will discuss again this part in next lecture in short class. Okay, because there are lots of slide here. Okay, so thank you.